aminophylline, amphetamine, adenosine, augmentin, and rifampicin, amoxicillin, penicillin, heparin, and warfarin, and estrogen, progesterone, and canesten, and chloroquine. There's bendroflumethiazide, and also cyclophosphamide, and metoclopramide, acetazolamide, tropicamide, loperamide, amiloride, and cyclizine, and furosemide.
At the completion of this presentation, the participants will be able to describe different types of drug interactions associated with the use of drugs, recognize the clinical drug interactions associated with drugs, and provide an appropriate recommendations to manage these drug interactions. Drug interaction. It is the modification of the effect of one drug by the prior or concomitant administration of another. The mechanisms of drug interactions are divided into two. So the first one is the pharmacokinetics. It involves the effect of drug on another drug kinetic that includes the absorption, the distribution, the metabolism, and the excretion. Next is the pharmacodynamic interactions, which may include the synergism, the potentiation, the addition, and the antagonism. First one is drug interactions affecting absorption. First is the changes in pH. The rate of absorption by passive diffusion is limited by the solubility or dissolution of a compound in gastric fluid. Basic drugs are more soluble in acidic fluids and acidic drugs are more soluble in basic fluids. These interactions can be clinically significant. For example, antacids decrease the tablet dissolution of ketoconazole, which is acidic. Another example are H2 receptor antagonists, which might also decrease the tablet dissolution of ketoconazole. Therefore, these drugs must be separated by at least 2 hours in the time of administration of both. Next is the chelation adsorption. Drugs may form insoluble complexes by chelation in the gastrointestinal tract. Chelations involve the formation of a ring structure between a metal ion, such as aluminum, magnesium, iron, and to a lesser degree calcium, in an organic molecules like anti-infective medication, which results in an insoluble compound that is unable to permeate the intestinal mucosa because of the lack of drug dissolution. For example, tetracycline interacts with iron preparations or milk, which results in absorbable complex. Another one is antacids, such as aluminum or magnesium hydroxide, which results in a decreased absorption of ciprofloxacin by 85% due to chelation. Next is the altered intestinal bacteria flora. For example, antibiotics kills the microflora of GIT, which reduces the absorption of oral contraceptives and results in unwanted pregnancy. The last one is the alteration of GIT motility. The presence or absence of food can affect the absorption of anti-infectives by a variety of mechanisms. High-fat meals can significantly increase the extent of absorption of fat-soluble compounds. Here are the following examples: purgatives, which decrease absorption; antidepressants and anticholinergic drugs like atropine, which might decrease gastric emptying and delay absorption; and the prokinetics like metoclopramide, which increases the gastric emptying and absorption. One is drug interactions affecting distribution. First is the displaced protein binding. It depends on the affinity of the drug to plasma protein. The most likely bound drugs is capable to displace others, and the free drug is increased by displacement by another drug with higher affinity. For example, phenytoin is highly bound to plasma protein, as well as glutamide and warfarin. The drugs that displaces these agents are aspirin, sulfonamides, and phenobutazone, metabolism. So let us discuss first what is altered metabolism. It is the effect of one drug on the metabolism of the other is well documented. The liver is the major site of drug metabolism, but other organs can also do. CYP450 family is the major metabolizing enzyme in phase 1. Therefore, the effect of drugs on the rate of metabolism of others can involve the following examples: